My name is Murari Vasudevan. I'm tech director at SYBO Games in Copenhagen. SYBO started with two Danish animators, Sylvester and Bodhi, and hence SYBO. It grew from there on to be Subway Surfers, and then the team grew and grew. And now it's a total of 115 people, and we're still growing. SYBO's culture, in a nutshell, is creativity by very definition. And it's a little different from other game studios, which have come from sort of a mixture of a tech founder and maybe a product founder, whereas these are entirely sort of art-driven. It's all about making things that are really fun and engaging right from the start. Creativity is one of the core values. It's also about building a kinder world and empathize with each other and understand and tolerate each other in a much better way, and trying to take our platform, which is quite a big audience. We have monthly users in the orders of hundreds of millions of people. So we're trying to use that platform for good. Actually, last year in September, we started the run-up to our 10-year anniversary, which culminates this May. It is something that we've been building up with every month. And there was the Green Game Jam activation, which was also the ecology one, Play to Plant. And in Subway Surfers, we launched a special character named Cleo, which was dubbed the Runner of Kindness. Within doing that, we also partnered with the Born This Way Foundation, which was started by Lady Gaga and her mother, as a way to promote kindness in daily interactions between people and empathy, and trying to build a kinder world. And then we also had our players sign a pledge towards the Born This Way Foundation within the game. Each day you had to do a daily act of kindness. People kept coming back and posting about what they did, and so this was trying to build a community and being kinder to people in your neighborhood, in your world. Then we had a hashtag around it, was BeKind21. The Playing for the Planet initiative is a global alliance of games companies all around the world. And it's an effort to sort of say, okay, we're gonna try and help combat the climate and the biodiversity crises. And the pledge is that the companies take commitments towards reducing their own footprint, but it's also by having activations running within the games themselves. For example, we have a yearly Green Game Jam that we take part in, where companies come up with ideas for how to engage their players around sort of green topics. That is the Playing for the Planet Alliance, and within that we are a proud member. We've been building up to this 10-year anniversary. What we have is a very special themed event that we're calling Super Surfers, where players can participate with the ultimate prize that they get immortalized as a Subway Surfers character. We feel is a huge thank you to the fans, and we can't wait to see what happens. My hopes for the future of gaming are that we see many different kinds of games coming from many more diverse places and voices, enable people to feel empathy and interact with their world in different ways. So for me, XR is a really inspiring place, both VR and AR, just mainly because of the potential that it gives players to put themselves outside of their own immediate perspectives and into others. So I think that for me is my hope, that it becomes a really kinder, more beautiful place. It makes the world a kinder, more beautiful place, and that we can also contribute towards saving the planet, as ambitious as it sounds.